While mosquitoes are beneficial to many, like birds, bats, and fish, they certainly can cause problems to humans and our health. Do you know what the most dangerous animal on Earth
is? That's right, mosquitoes.
Dr. Buck here to help you learn the scientific facts to stay safe and do our part to reduce the mosquito populations. I have received dozens of questions about mosquitoes. How do I keep them from biting me? Why do mosquito bites itch? Can a mosquito send me to the hospital? Do bugs carry viruses that humans can get? What is the most dangerous insect? Mosquitoes begin their life cycle just like every other insect, as an egg. Mosquitoes lay their eggs at the edge of water or even in water, not just ponds or lakes or puddles, or it's any standing water, flower pots, toys, gutters, just a tiny bit of water. Even as small as a tablespoon of water, is where the eggs are laid. Mosquitoes undergo complete metamorphosis, that four-stage life cycle, so the hatchlings look nothing like the adults.
The second-stage hatchling larvae are called wrigglers. So yes, they are wormy-like. They wriggle down from the surface of the water, eat algae or plankton. They are very beneficial to fish in ponds and lakes, providing a delicious meal, but at our houses and standing water, not so much. They are just breeding grounds for more mosquitoes.
Life stage 3 is the pupa, another short 2 to 3 day cycle. As a pupa, they do not eat. They remain as pupa until the body of the newly formed adult flying mosquito emerges from the pupa's skin and leaves the water. Upon emerging as adults, male and female mosquitoes eat plant nectar. Almost immediately as an adult, the female mosquito needs to grow eggs, and she needs lots of nutrients, and blood is the perfect food. Here's the big problem. Mama mosquito isn't too picky on who she bites, and if she bites an animal or a person infected with a parasite, a bacterial, or a viral disease, she certainly doesn't care. She just carries that disease into the next bite. An affected mosquito can carry malaria, West Nile virus, and many, many other diseases. You may not even notice that a mosquito is biting you and sucking your blood. I know I don't. She injects a chemical with her saliva called an anticoagulant to prevent your blood from clotting, and it makes it easy to siphon her supper. Some of us are quite reactive to bites with big welts and itch, and others barely notice a bite. Most people are somewhere in between. This is because our own bodies produce chemicals called histamines to protect from the mosquito's chemical. Of course, not every mosquito carries a disease, so not every mosquito bite will make you sick. We just need to be careful all the time so that you don't get bitten in the first place. How do we protect ourselves? Well, we might avoid playing outside during peak mosquito time.
Adults can spray your clothing and exposed skin to keep the biters away.
Empty any standing water in your yard. Remember to look for buckets, tire swings, gutters, toys. The more places to lay eggs mean more mosquitoes and more mosquito bites. If you do get a bite, which we all do, there's no need to panic. Wash bites with soapy water and add an anti-itch cream to keep you from scratching. Be aware so that if you do start feeling sick, you can tell an adult so they can monitor your symptoms and decide if you need to see a doctor. Remember, knowledge is power, even in the garden. Thanks for watching. If you like our show, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out. And until next time, see you in the garden.
Ask Dr. Bug originates from the Kids Ask Dr. Bug column, written by Dr. Tamra Reall, horticultural specialist with the University of Missouri Extension. Her column can be found in garden publications, newsletters, and Extension websites. Do you have a question for Dr. Bug? Send them to reallt@missouri.edu. Put Ask Dr. Bug in the subject and include your name and age, or ask your questions online at the address listed here.